إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. At the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask us about our deeds. So this is the issue to prepare for that day. Are you ready for these questions or not? And before the day of judgment in the grave, every single one of us will be asked about his deeds. So we should be prepared for these questions. And we should, of course, we have to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's see the ayat and the hadith which mentioned the questions in the Quran and Sunnah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَوَرَبِّكَ لَنَسْأَلَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ عَمَّا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. So by your Lord, we will surely question them all about what they used to. So don't think that you are going to do certain things even if you are alone in a hidden place, darkness, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not register that. Everything will be registered and you will be questioned about your deeds. As he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith, and surely you will meet your Lord. Surely you will meet your Lord and he will ask you about your deeds. Subhanallah. It is not a policeman. It is not a teacher. It is not a parliament. It is the day of judgment. It is your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, "Sa'idu billahi min adhab al-qabr." Seek refuge from the punishment of the grave. There is a punishment in the grave. Yes. Sa'idu billah. And this is what we are doing in every salah at the end. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from the adab al-qabr, adab jahannam. Sa'idu billahi min adab al-qabr. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, after we finish the janazah, that this person will hear the steps of people who buried him, subhanallah. Then two angels come to this man. They ask him, "What is your religion?" "My religion is Islam." "Who is your prophet? Who is your messenger?" "Rasuli Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." "Who is your Lord?" "My Lord is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell them to open a door for him from paradise. So he will enjoy the time in his grave because he believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the last day, because he was a good and true believer. And on the other hand, al-kafir al-munafiq, the disbeliever, they will ask him, "Who's your Lord?" "Huh? Huh? La adri. I don't know." "What is your religion?" "Huh? Huh? La adri. I don't know." "Who's your messenger?" "Huh? Huh? La adri. I don't know." Subhanallah. He doesn't know. But many times in this dunya, he hears "Ashhadu anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah" from the Adhan. He read the books. But subhanallah, at the day of judgment, only the useful knowledge will be with you, with your faith. then he will be punished in his grave. So, every one of us will be asked these three questions in the grave. Also, we will be asked on the day of judgment. And what will be the first thing that we'll be asked about? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the first of his deeds for which a man will be taken into account on the day of resurrection will be his salah. The first thing is your salah. It is not your father. It is not your wealth. It is not your education. It is your salah. Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. Not the Taraweeh, not Qiyam al-Layl, the Fard Salah. So what will be your answer? Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, if it is sound, he will be saved and successful. Subhanallah. The success is related with your Salah. The success in Najah, wal Falah. Winning is related with your salah. Who is the winner? Those who pray. As simple as that. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not mention anything else with this hadith. The first thing is your salah. If it is sound, then you will be saved. Successful. But if it is unsound, he will be unfortunate and miserable. Subhanallah. This is the main thing, your salah. No need for a person who is perfect, polite, I mean his akhlaq, generous, fasting, giving zakah, but he's not praying. He is in the hellfire wal iyadu billah. The main thing is your salah. This is the first thing you will be asked about at the day of judgment. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam also mentioned about the questions. He said sallallahu alayhi wasallam, man's feet will not move on the day of resurrection before he is asked about his life. How did he consume it? His knowledge. What did he do with it? His wealth. How did he earn it? And how did he dispose of it? And about his body. How did he wear it out? Subhanallah. Your life, 50 years, 60 years, 70 years, more or less, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to ask you about your life, your wealth, your health. We will be asked about everything, brothers and sisters. Are we using the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to please Him? Or we are using the ni'mah of Allah to disobey Him. We should use all of the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the meaning of shukr. To be thankful, to use the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His obedience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ إِنَّ السَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرَ وَالْفُؤَادَ كُلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْؤُولًا. And don't pursue that of which you have no knowledge. Indeed, the hearing, the sight, and the heart about all those one will be questioned. Anything you are hearing, you are watching, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to ask you about everything. So if you are thinking your shaitan told you to see the haram, to hear the haram, stop him and think, are you ready to answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Oh Allah, I was doing the haram, I was watching the haram. Are you brave to say this before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Of course we are not ready for that. But the shaitan makes us to forget that meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned also the question about those who kill, that the victim, the killed person, will come at the day of judgment. His head on his hands. تَشْخُبُ دَمًا, bleeding. His vessels are bleeding. He's pulling the one who killed him. Oh Allah, ask him why did he kill me? Because of what? Because of football? Because of a woman? Because of a business? Because of what? Because of jihad? This is great in the jihad, fi sabilillah. But because of money? Because of dunya? You kill your brothers, your sisters, your parents, your children? You should be prepared for that question at the day of judgment. Maybe some people, brothers, sisters, think that the small things are okay. No one will ask us about that. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayah, then on that day, you shall be asked about the delights. Az-Zubayr ibn al-Awwam said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, radiyallahu ta'ala, he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Rasulullah, which are the delights that we will be asked about? Oh, so it is only the two black things, at-tamr wal-ma, dates and water. It is only al-aswadan, they are called al-aswadan, even not al-abyadan, aswadan, dates and water. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, but it is what shall come. Yes, it means Allah will ask you even about the dates, the water. Subhanallah. Can you imagine, brothers, sisters, that who is Zubayr radiyallahu ta'ala? And what was the time of Zubayr radiyallahu ta'ala? It is the time of jihad. It is the time of the Quran. It is the time of sacrifice. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, you will be asked even about al-aswadan. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده أما بعد. Even the prophets عليهم الصلاة والسلام will be asked. فَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الَّذِينَ أُرْسِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. Also Allah will ask Nuh, وموسى وعيسى ومحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. It is not only the normal people, also the prophets عليهم الصلاة والسلام. Then we will surely question those to whom was sent the message, and we will surely question the messengers. As he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith, Ya Nuh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked Nuh, Hal ballaght? Did you convey my message to people? Yes. Yes, oh my Lord. I did. I told them about the tawheed, about your message. I convey your message in a perfect way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to ask Nuh alayhi salatu wa sallam. And it is not enough. It is not only that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell Nuh, who is your witness? So it is not easy, brothers, sisters, that you say the answer and khalas. Where are your witnesses? It is my nation. Come, the nation of Nuh. You are the nation of Nuh? Yes. Did Nuh convey you the message, my message to you? No. Never. Subhanallah. 950 years. They denied 950 years. Subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to ask people and also the messengers alayhim salatu wassalam. Then the ummah of Muhammad will be the witnesses of Nuh, for Nuh alayhi salatu wassalam. And I like to end with this ayah, brothers, sisters. And I think we are reading this ayat every day. But we should reflect, we should understand We should put in this in our mind these ayat, two ayah. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. So whoever does an ounce weight, it is 1 gram, 0.5 gram, it is 0.1 gram, very, very small thing, nothing, Allah is going to ask you about that deed. It is good or bad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to ask you about that deed. If it is good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you. If it is bad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you what you deserve. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minin wal mu'minat wal muslimin wal muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qareeb mujib ad da'awat ya rabb al alamin aminna fi awtanina ya rabb al alamin rabbana آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم احبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق العصيان واجعلنا اللهم من المؤمنين الراشدين يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظ الشباب والبنات. اللهم احفظ الشباب والبنات. اللهم احفظ الشباب والبنات. اللهم احفظنا من الأوبئة يا رب العالمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا واجمعنا معهم في الفردوس يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.